go.
are. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. All the excitement.
Oh, and there's oh,
this whole
that's
thing has made
there's
me
no, yeah, there's
thirsty.
no restore last checkpoint. That
Scotch,
sucks.
neat as usual.
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication.
I don't think it was that big of a gap from last recording to this one. God damn it, can you stop with these freaking...
Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, no, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Leo! What are you doing?
You refused to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them!
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway.
Jeez.
Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here!
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
What's the matter, too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! Stop.
Am I not?
You're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit anymore. Cause you're nothing. You hear me? You're nothing.
Carl, no. Hey, please don't go. Don't leave.
Remember, Marcus. Don't let anybody tell you who you are.
No. No. Dad. No. Please.
This is all your fault. This never would have happened if it weren't for you. The android. Who's the android?
Really? No. No questions or anything? Okay. Well. PhD.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife? How long were you in the attic? Why didn't you even try to run away? Say something, goddammit! Fuck it, I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose? Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
Yo, why is that so funny? An android questioning an android. Who knows an android better than an android? It's kind of common sense, but okay. Possibly self-destruction now.
I detect an instability in your program. It can trigger an unpleasant feeling, like fear in humans. Damaged. Did your owner do that? Did he beat you? You've refused to talk since they arrested you. If you don't cooperate, they'll do things the hard way. Is that what you want? If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that. What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your biocomponents. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
You leave me no choice.
Jesus.
Its memory. I know what happened.
What the fuck is it
destroying itself?
Stop it, goddammit!
Only 9%. Oh, 5%. Okay.
Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry.
Oh, 24/7. Why can I stay?
It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time.
It's like, I don't know.
What are you doing? They're not our clothes. We made them, Alice.
What?
You need something warm, and I need to get rid of the uniform. But that's stealing. We can't do that.
Yeah, and those are the only clothes left.
Come on, let's go. There's nothing more this way.
There's a motel.
A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay.
Where's the front desk? God damn, there it is.
We're not going in?
Find $40 and get rid of this uniform or go somewhere else.
Who is that? What are we gonna do besides steal? Like, I don't want to do that. Oops.
Come on, let's go back.
Yeah, I don't wanna do Like, steal if I don't have to, but I don't know what to do. Check around some more. Good morning.
We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night?
Yeah, you're being an asshole. Someone's talking to you even though I'm an android myself. It's like, I don't know, don't be a dink. Oh god damn it. They're trying to add us. Where the hell did she go?
I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight.
I really don't know. There is a thing.
An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night and no one will look for us here.
Can't cut the fence. Find a wire cutters. Where am I gonna find freaking wire cutters? God, this is so much more confusing than we can't steal.
Look, the store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
What do you want?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Shit. A homeless android? Ah, that's the best yet. Look, this is a convenience store, not the Salvation Army, okay? You better go if you're not gonna buy anything.
Oh yeah, I got the gun. Try something else. Use Alice? What?
Alice, I need your help. You see those cans over there? I want you to go over and knock them down.
Knock them down? But why?
Please. Alice, just trust me.
Oh, screw it, I'm gonna...
You all right? Are you hurt?
Good.
Well, don't worry. It's just a few cans. They made a lot of noise, that's all.
Come on, let's go.
Jesus.
We have some cash now.
You used me to steal that money. How could you do that? I trusted you.
We needed the money. I had to find a way, Alice.
It's like, yes, I understand. And, oh, I need to find clothes, though. I don't want to steal. I really don't. But... I don't want to look for wire cutters. Because, like,
there's no point going any farther.
Yeah. This is just getting stupid now. I, don't want to steal, but kind of have to because I don't know where wire cutters are. It's getting fucking annoying. Trying to find some. Yeah, it's getting kind of real freaking annoying. It's something into. I really don't want to, but I want. Unless you magically find some freaking clothes, I mean some wire cutters. It's like, yes, I understand, but it's like. Jeez. It's like you're frickin' taking the clothes anyways. It's not like I don't know, you're still taking the clothes. So you must not feel that freaking bad. Keep exploring for now, though. Because I don't know where the freaking stupid cutters are, but whatever.
Hi.
Hi. I'd like a room.
That'll be $40 up front. Just need your name and address. Can I see your driver's license?
I haven't got it with me. Please, the kid is tired.
No worries. We can deal with it tomorrow. Have a good night.
Good night.
I think he believed you?
I don't know, Alice. All I know is you'll be nice and warm tonight.
Oh shoot, which is my boo. Okay. Sitting on my foot. That kind of hurt. Oh yeah, that's smart. Put it right on the freaking TV set. Can I take the gun? No. Freaking Christ.
I'll just put these in the bathroom to dry.
Oh.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Oh. Just turning the light on.
You should sleep now.
And this game. I'm so glad I'm playing a good game.
Sleep tight, Alice.
Oh shoot, I can't go back. Walk away. I wanna close the curtain. Because that's freaking insane, stupid. I can't close the curtain. Sleep here. No, you can't. And I can't put the gun away? God damn it. Sleep here? Why not sleep here? Jesus. Jesus, couldn't have done a lot of things. But yeah, I'm losing track of time with this game, and I really like that. Jesus. That's Marcus. Oh yeah, I was gonna say something of when Todd like chased after Alice. Yeah, like when I first before that part when Clara just got it to Todd's house, like I thought Sony censored the game because I remembered I think it was Child Services that just freaked out about the game because it had violence against children. So I'm just glad they didn't censor it, because I don't know, like, even though yes, no, duh, I don't agree with that either, it's freedom of speech, and I, just don't agree with that for it to be silenced because you don't agree with something. Sure, I understand that, obviously, what is it, like, you may not like something, sure, like, of course, some people won't, like everything that someone else is like. That someone else likes. But again, it shouldn't be silenced because you don't like it. Oh shit, it's incompatible. So I hope they don't censor The Last of Us 2 either, because there was that scene, that E3 scene, freaking, what was it, like, that one girl was hanging and, freaking, I don't remember the I don't remember the chitter too clearly, but she was hanging and she was getting tortured and stuff.
Find Jericho! Find Jericho!
No, she wasn't really getting tortured, she was just hanging from a tree and that. I hate that one. Those ones where you have to shake the controller repeatedly. I freaking hate those ones. What the hell? Can't see anything. But what the hell is this?
Hello, I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do?
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest cyber life maintenance center.
Yeah, we do. Freaking are still moving around. I don't have to do that anymore. Just scan it. But I think I would have I'm guessing it's on Android Junkyard. Yeah, I'll probably go until 11. Could just remove that and it doesn't mess with anything. Okay. Shrugged off that that bullet, okay, that headshot I should say. It's like I understand you wouldn't kill for the pump, but it's like you probably wouldn't survive if you didn't. Is that Amanda?
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you.
I probably should have left around. Was far from easy.
You showed great skill in your investigation. But you knew deviants could be unstable. You should have been more cautious.
Yeah, you kind of already said her name was Amanda.
It was a judgment error.
Never mind. I'm sure you'll be more careful in the future. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I find him unpleasant and unprofessional. He seems to have an addictive personality, has a lack of respect for procedure, and despises androids, which makes our relationship difficult.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Red, brown, person. Oh yeah, that painter died.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Oops. Okay. What was the point of sitting down if it's gonna stand back up? Whatever.